Last time, we picked the questions with the three forms of interrogation. Now, we will be doing the answers to the questions when we have these three forms of interrogation. Now, which are the ways in which you can answer a question? For example, do you speak French? If this is the question. Vous parlez français? Est-ce que vous parlez français? Parlez-vous français? Any way this question can be framed. Now, how would we answer it? Now, there are two ways of answering this question. The first way, vous parlez français? Yes, I speak French. So, oui, je or nous parlons français. Je parle français. Oui, je parle français. Yes, I speak French. No, I do not speak French. No, je ne parle pas français. Now, as you know, the negation ne pas is put with the verb that is conjugated. Here in this question, we have just one verb. Now, whenever you have a question which starts with who, the answer can be in je or nous. Both are accepted. Just make sure that the verb that you put corresponds with the pronoun that you put in the beginning. Because if you're asking an adult, vous parlez français, if you're asking me, I would say je, no, and not nous. You're asking me, so I would reply as je. But if you're asking a group of persons, then the answer can be in nous also. So here we have oui, no, yes, no. So we understand that oui means yes for a positive answer. No means no for a negative answer. There is one more peculiar word in French, which does not exist in our language, English or Hindi. It doesn't exist in English or Hindi. The word is si. Now, si is the word which means yes, but for a negative question. Now, what does that mean? We start our sentence with C. We reply in C. Now, this is not that C. Jo if wala use hota C. Ye if wala C nahi. Now, you need to distinguish. There are two meanings for this C. Ye if whether wala C nahi. Ye C jo hai, this C is used for saying yes to a negative question. For example, if you ask me, don't you stay in Delhi? Or you don't stay in Delhi? So this is a negative question, but I want to say, yes, I stay in Delhi. Yes, I stay in Delhi. So I would not start with this yes, because the question is negative. Note, please pay attention here. Bring all your attention here, because this is something that doesn't exist in your language. Oui means yes for a positive sentence. The question was, do you speak French? You said, yes, I speak French. You started the answer with oui. Then the question was, vous parlez français, you speak French, but in case you don't speak French, you would say, no, je ne parle pas français. I don't speak French. We don't speak French. What if the question was negative? In the sense, if this question was, vous ne parlez pas français, you don't speak French. And you have to say, I speak French. नहीं मैं बोलता हूँ. हम हिंदी में बोलते हैं नहीं मैं बोलता हूँ. हम नहीं से शुरू करते हैं. ठीक है हाँ मैं बोलता हूँ नहीं नहीं मैं बोलता हूँ. ठीक है In different languages, the language structure, the sentence structure, the vocabulary is different. It is not exactly the same like in मतलब two languages cannot run parallel. You cannot have exactly the same meaning. So I am just giving you the closest translation possible, the closest meaning possible in our mother tongue or in English. So C is yes for a negative question. Please write this down. V is yes, positively. No is no. And C is yes for a negative question. I will give you an example right now on the board. Now, if this same question, I will use the same question. If the same question was in negative, Vous ne parlez pas français? You don't speak French. Now, if I have to say, yes, I speak French, I will start the answer with, si, je parle français. Si, je parle français. Now, I can also say, no, I don't speak French. Even if the question is negative, the answer can also be negative. C is used for a positive answer for a negative question. We can also have a negative answer, no? What will we put for a negative answer? No. No. Je ne parle pas français. No, I don't speak French. So if the question is positive, a normal question, a statement, a positive statement, vous parlez français, the answer can be both yes or no. It can be positive or it can be negative. When the question is negative specifically, because this is something that you need to know. When the question is negative, and you want to say a positive answer, you want to give a positive answer, then the answer would be si je parle français. The answer will start with si. And you can also have a negative answer for a negative question. Then we will write no, je ne parle pas français. So I hope this much is clear. Okay, now after having done the question answer of we, no, and see, now I will share with you how to frame questions when the answer is in we, no, and see. Let's do that. And how can we recognize how to structure our question? Because we, no, and see are different, are the answers for different responses, like V is positive, no is negative, C is positive for a negative question. Now, I will share three examples with you. We oui, je sois. Yes, I am thirsty. Oui, je sois. Now, I have always told you, whenever you want to form a question wherein the response starts with yes, no, or C, we, no, or C, the question, you should always try to frame the question with ESC formation. You will never go wrong. ESC, the answer is je. So the question would be you. Est-ce que tu as soif? Are you thirsty? Yes, I'm thirsty. So this would be the probable question. Now, we have another response. No. Je ne suis pas American. No, I'm not American. No, I am not American. What could be the probable question? Now here, we start the question with Est-ce? Are you American? Est-ce? Q-A America? Are you American? Est-ce que tu es américain? Non, je ne suis pas américain. Est-ce que tu es américain? You American. You said, no, I'm not American. Now, if you had to frame a question like, est-ce que tu n'es pas américain? Aren't you American? If you ask me, okay? If you ask me this question, the first question, are you American? I will say, no, I'm not American. So this is the first question. If you ask me, aren't you American? So no, I'm not American. I may look like, but I don't like Americans. Let's think about somebody else, some other race. So, are you American? Are you American? I said, no, I'm not American. Now the question here could be negative also. Aren't you American? And I would still say, no, I'm not American. Est-ce que tu n'es pas américain? Aren't you American? No, I'm not American. If the answer is positive, the question will be positive. If the answer is negative, if the answer is negative, the question can be positive or negative both. But if the answer is starting with C, the question will be negative. For example, C. Si j'ai un stylo. Yes, I have a pen. So what would be the probable question that you would have asked when I say, yes, I have a pen? And you have to ask a negative question. Est-ce que tu n'as pas, the question has to be negative, no? Est-ce que tu n'as pas un stylo? Est-ce que tu n'as pas de stylo? Now, this is something that needs to be taken care of. Then you are doing trouver la question. Then it is not only the matter of forming a question, framing the questions. No, you have to take care of many other things. Adjective possessive, if we have used adjective possessive in the answer, then how would you convert that adjective possessive according to the subject of the sentence? Okay, now you have to accord it. Agar my mein, I have my pen, the question would be, do you have your pen? So my ko your mein change karna hai. Article dekhna hai. You have to take care of all these things. That you need to take care of the article also. The answer is positive, but you know that when the answer is positive and it starts with C, the question would have been negative. And when the question has to be negative, then you have to take care of the article also. Are you understanding? Everything in a language is interlinked. And that is the reason I have been doing all the basic concepts every time we start our new session. Okay? Every time we do everything that we've done till now. Why so? Because everything is interlinked. When you're doing trouver la question, you're not just doing trouver la question. You can see all these things. Because everything is coming into account. Article bhi aa rahe hai, adjective possessive bhi aa rahe hai, sab cheeze aa rahi hai, pronouns bhi aa rahe hai, subject pronoun bhi change ho raha hai, sab kuch ikkathe complementary chal raha hai, integrated chal raha hai. Nothing is isolated. Ki jab hum iska question kar rahe hain to sirf isi ka aayega, wo sirf class 4 and 5 mein aata. That you were doing just one question, to usi pe focus karte the. Now, whenever you will have sentences in your question paper, the sentences will have every aspect of grammar. Every part of speech will be involved. And you need to know kaha pe kya change karna hai. Now, I will repeat this again. Whenever we have answers starting with we, no, and see, how do we frame a question? Now, whenever the answer starts with yes, please remember, question positive में ही होगा, क्योंकि अगर yes होता और question negative होता तो C लगता ना, इसका question तो negative हो ही नहीं सकता, because negative question के positive answer के लिए हम C use करते हैं. I just told you for a negative question and if we have a positive answer then we would have used C and not we. Understood? Then if the question, if the answer starts with no, then the question can be positive or negative both. For example, I gave you this very simple example. No, I'm not American. Okay, no, I'm not. No, I don't speak Chinese. So you could have asked me, do you speak Chinese? I would say no. That would be a positive question. If you had asked me, don't you speak Chinese? No way. I only know English, Hindi, Punjabi, and French. Chinese, abhi tak, I don't know. So the question could be positive or negative when the answer is negative. But take care. Whenever you frame a negative question, if there is any article involved, you need to take care of the fact that negation mein article change hota hai. कौन सा आर्टिकल चेंज होता है, सारे रूल्स नेगेशन के याद रख के नेगेशन में सेंटेंस को फ्रेम करना है. यू नीड टू रिमेंबर द रूल्स ऑफ नेगेशन व्हाइल फ्रेमिंग एनी क्वेश्चन एनी सेंटेंस इन और इन द नेगेटिव फॉर्म. क्योर व्हेन द आंसर स्टार्ट्स विद सी, ठीक है, द आंसर इज स्टार्टिंग विद सी. नाउ यू नो दैट व्हेनेवर वी हैव द आंसर स्टार्टिंग विद सी द क्वेश्चन हैज टू बी नेगेटिव. So we framed a negative question and we took into account that while I'm seeing the answer has an article involved. Now, if I have to put this sentence into a negative question, I will have to change the article also. So I have changed this article here. So you need to take care all the aspects of grammar while framing question or while doing anything. The entire grammar is interlinked. So I hope now three forms of interrogation, after three forms of interrogation, this was the video and of the answers starting with B, no, and C and how to frame the questions also for when you have these answers. And I hope this is clear. Okay. Thank you.